What's up, y'all? It's Demogenide. It's time for another one. So, I was going to talk about something else today, but I saw this article, and a bunch of people were talking about it, too. So, I said, you know what? Let me put my two cents on it, because when I looked into what they were talking about, I was like, yeah, this needs to be discussed. And it's very annoying that we have to discuss things like this yet again. So, what I'm talking about is this article from Screen Rant, and it says, Survey says political beliefs may explain why fans don't like The Last Jedi. Okay. Let's get this straight. And I'm going to say this as crystal clear as I can say this. The Last Jedi was a terrible, terrible movie. Objectively speaking. And if you want to subjectively speaking, it was the worst of the worst dumpster fire I've ever seen in my life. Like, The Last Jedi is the bar for dumpster fires for movies that I have now. I think, I'm almost going to say that I've never seen this movie, but I heard about it. The Room. I'm going to say The Room is probably better than The Last Jedi. The Room is bad on a level that it was good. It was so bad that it was good. The Last Jedi was depressingly bad. But here's the thing that's so funny about that. This is the biggest thing I want to talk about. We are 6 months away from the Rise of Skywalker. That means that we are just about literally a year and a half past when The Last Jedi came out. Because that was in 2017, right? Why are we still talking about The Last Jedi? Do you guys like hitting the hornet's nest? And I think that's what it is. I honestly, because you see all these articles and stuff being put up by you know, my fellow content creators that we all are the reactionary, we're always upset, stuff like that, blah, blah, blah. No, let's get this straight. This is another thing I need to talk about. What we do is we have to counter whatever this nonsense is out here. Because if this stuff keeps getting put out there, this would be the narrative that they are already pushing hard body. They're pushing it so hard that, you know, if we don't say anything, this will roll over everything and everybody will believe it. Because the funny thing about it is when you look at this article, and again, as typical, I will put this full article in there. I only took out two paragraphs because it goes along with what I need to discuss. And here we go. So, here's what the article says. It says, a survey on the Star Wars fandom has found that political beliefs could be the reason why many fans dislike The Last Jedi. Given how divisive The Last Jedi was, it should come to no surprise that the Star Wars fans have some pretty strong opinions about the 8th installment of the long-running franchise. Of course, Star Wars The Last Jedi got plenty of glowing reviews from shows, of course, but a vocal minority condemned the film. Some Star Wars fans expressed their disdain for The Last Jedi's supposedly feminist politics and harassing the actor Kelly Marie Tran, who plays the resistance fighter Rose Tico, to the extent that she ended up quitting social media. As it turns out, political beliefs may influence how some fans viewed the follow-up Star Wars Force, The Force Awakens. The follow-up to Star Wars Force Awakens, sorry. A couple things unpacking here. So, if we're a vocal minority, why is this conversation still happening? Because, see, it's almost like the yin versus yang. You know, one has to be the light and the dark. So, if we were just a small bit of the yin or yang, whichever one you want us to be, you wouldn't need to constantly put this out there to constantly tell people, oh, it's a vocal minority, it's a vocal minority, it's a vocal minority. You got to keep saying that because you want people to believe that. Because think about this here. If we're such a vocal minority, what happened with Solo? You should have, again, Solo is basically ground zero to how effective the fandom menace is. And obviously it wasn't just us, but it, you know, we did play a good part of it, I would like to believe. If we're such a small minority of a group of people, why was Solo a flop? I'm just saying. And needless to say, I mean, when you sit there and talk about the, you know, quote-unquote feminist politics, which I like to call it agenda-based entertainment. Entertainment should be free of agendas. I mean, yes, you can have an agenda in it if it goes with the story. But if you're taking something out of the story from this real world and then putting it into the story and just making that not go with the story, it doesn't match. You remember those games you used to play as a kid where you had the little blocks? You had to put them, you know, the triangles, the squares, the circles, you had to put them inside the box, you know, put them in the right shapes. It's kind of like taking a circle and trying to put it into a square. You know, just for layman's terms for people like that. So, when you do stuff like that, it doesn't work. Obviously, if it's part of another, people say, oh, well, you know, the Phantom Menace. I keep mixing that up, sorry. The Phantom Menace had politics in it. Yes, it did, but it went along with the story. It was part of the story. But when you take, you know, and I was talking to Crystal McGee over the weekend on my live stream. Check that out if you haven't. And I was saying how one of the things that stood out with, even with The Force Awakens, is when Finn kept trying to, you know, grab Rey's hand and say, oh, no, hold my hand. I'm like, why? Why was that put in there? Why was that necessary to be put in there? Like, first off, if you didn't want that to be a situation, you didn't have to have that written into the story to begin with. That's how you make that story work. And if you didn't want to have it be a thing, but by him extending his hand to her and then her saying, "Don't grab my hand," that stands out. You could either not had that put in there at all, or just have her grab his hand. It's not like it's the end of the world if you grab her hand. I'm just saying. But it's simple things like that going forward. But the point I was going to make is, it's not even just when you talk about The Last Jedi and everything. It's like everything is basically having this sprinkle of agenda-based entertainment placed inside of the films that we're supposed to be getting, that it seems like everything's basically failing. Like, this whole summer has been a dumpster fire. I mean, aside from Alita, which didn't have that situation, and John Wick, which didn't have that situation put in there, those are the standout movies so far. They really were. I'm sorry. Those two were the best ones so far this year, because they didn't have any agenda-based entertainment thrown into it. It was just, you know, classic. It was a classic shoot 'em up movie and a classic, you know, strong hero movie put together. But again, with the Kelly Marie Tran thing, can we please stop with that? It's like every time we have a Star Wars story, article, anything, you gotta throw in Kelly Marie Tran. I brought up in a few videos back about how Tim Rose was getting actually harassed. Actually. Mark Hamill actually harassed. Like, actually. Like, there's screenshots of it. Like, again, there was a thing about somebody doing some crazy stuff on Kelly Marie Tran's Wikipedia. Okay, that was the one instance. That was Wikipedia. That wasn't social media. That, you know, we didn't have this, you know, evidence, you know. And listen, it's not like we know that people have a problem with Rose Tico. It's not Kelly Marie Tran. It's Rose Tico. That character was terrible, okay? And I love how they say resistance fighter Rose Tico. She was not a resistance fighter. She's the resistance mechanic. That's what she was. Her sister was a resistance fighter. I mean, let's just be perfectly clear about that. Her sister, Paige Tico, was the resistance fighter. She was in the bottom of the ship cattle prodding people. Just saying. I'm just saying. But, yeah. So, when you go into this article, and I'm not going to go into this thing because it is going to annoy me very much. So, when you go into the article, it actually tells you, it says about, you know, they surveyed a bunch of people, and, like, they said, oh, well, if you, there was, like, the prequel haters. It's like the three versions or whatever. Listen. Again, I don't display my politics on my show. My show is not about politics. I mean, listen, I may have a political discussion here or there because it kind of, they always bleed this stuff into my entertainment. Excuse me. So yes, it does make a conversation of sorts. But as far as my political beliefs, you don't need to know them. Who cares about them? Okay? The movies suck. It's plain and simple. Your movies suck. It has nothing to do about being Republican, Democrat, you know. And of course, the thing you might, like, again, are there people out there who are women haters? There are guys out there that are women haters. There are women who are men haters. They exist in this world. But try to always lump everybody who had a problem with this movie, and then you go and do a survey out there and they say, oh, well, this works into my narrative. Let's just go ahead and say that this is what it was. I think it's very disingenuous, and it really doesn't help your situation. And what is it supposed to do, actually? Again, like I said, we have the Rise of Skywalker coming out. Why aren't you doing articles about that? Why aren't you pumping this up? Because I think, you know, that movie's probably going to be DOA. Because it's because of The Last Jedi. It's like, you spark that up to get people talking about Star Wars again. Which, I guess you can say I'm guilty of it because I'm talking about it. But again, the reason why we do this is to counter what they do. It's not about us being angry. It's about us, hey, listen, they're throwing something out there. We got to bounce it back. Bounce it back to them. You got to play tennis out here, because if you don't, they're going to just be throwing all these projectiles at us, and you know, we're going to get swamped. So we have to bounce them back over. So that's really what this is all about. And again, the movie was terrible. It's a year and a half past this movie, and you're still talking about how it's something other than the movie was terrible. How about you guys just admit the movie was terrible? You know, listen. Tell me the purpose of Leia doing the things she did. Tell me the purpose of Canto Bight. Tell me the purpose of Luke Skywalker trying to kill his nephew after he tried to save his father in Return of the Jedi. Tell me the purpose of that. Tell me the purpose of Rey not having any kind of training but being able to best Luke in a little skirmish and do everything that she's doing. And I don't want to hear Luke is in Mary Sue 2. No, he was not. He failed. He got his hand cut off. Anakin got his arm cut off, got burnt alive, basically. So it's not like there were no trials and tribulations for the heroes that we had back in the past. Even Yoda lost his match against Sidious. Granted, it was more or less like a draw almost, but they still lost. So if you want to say somebody who was OP, Yoda was OP. And he was presented as such because he was the Grand Master. He was put in that position of that. To start off with, Rey was not put in that position. Rey was put in a position as, you know, the not even a real hero's journey, but, you know, if he was trying to say that was a hero's journey, like, she would start out as the call, basically. But it didn't really go with the hero's journey, because where was her journey going? She's basically exactly the same as she was in The Force Awakens as she is now, except now she knows how, she already knew how to use a lightsaber, because she used a lightsaber in the beginning of the series. So, tell me, what are these things that stand out to you that I just said that makes this movie good? Just tell me. I mean, listen, I'm all ears. And if you like The Last Jedi, great, I'm happy for you. But don't sit there and say that the people who disliked it are a vocal minority and we have, you know, our beliefs are the reason why we didn't like the movie. The reason we didn't like the movie because the movie was terrible. Regardless of what you believe in, the movie was terrible. Okay? Just say it. Anyway, how do you guys feel about that? Like, share, subscribe, but of course, hit that notification bell so you get my bits when I drop. I'll catch y'all later. Peace.